Okay, so we're back. We have to admit that we kind of like we said, we're very limited as far as keeping order within our mind. And so oh, my bad. So we apologize for that, but okay, we're kind of we kind of remember something, and if that's not it, then we'll go with it anyways. Basically, the Ethiopic calendar is somewhere around 7,500 years. Now this end of the cycle, the Mayan age cycle, whatever, it's been oftentimes it's been said that it's actually counting 24,000 years. And however way you want to look at it, it's we know honestly we've known that it is this part right here. It is the darkness because spring, and then we have summer. We have Lion of Judah up here, and then we have fall, autumn, and then we have winter. But this is the most darkest place of winter. So this is like the Dark Ages. They're not the Dark Ages. We're kind of just putting that out there. Well, for some European nations, yeah, they were the Dark Ages. But we had already passed the Dark Ages. That's why our peoples were still building stuff and kind of trying to bring back to memory that which had been in the Dark Ages, which was forgotten. Now, Ethiopic calendar might be counting these last 8 days or this Sabbath. Okay, now we remember it had something to do with the sevens, with 3 times 7. And so basically counting down this cycle. So it would be actually if we add this up, that would be interesting to let's see. What are we trying to do? Times three. Well, that's actually kind of not that bad, I guess. At multiplying three, yeah, this is close to this. You see, some way or another, this is connected. This is 21,500 years, and this is 24,000 years, give or take, depending on precession. See, it's the whole technicality. Let's avoid that. That's not the point. The point is that there's a change, and we should welcome it. And if you have invested all of your heart, mind, and soul into death, then you never existed. But we find it funny how people are so have bought in so have really bought into the idea of dying and never even considered a chance of not dying. So here's your chance of not dying. Life can go on if ones are willing to adapt themselves to this, to evolve. Hey, this is funny. This is kind of like kind of gives us the idea of a cylinder, and kind of like, well, I guess we could already see the Mayan calendar at work in a sense. This is rotating like this, and then this will be rotating on a bigger scale. So nonetheless, back to the three perfect witnesses. Ethiopic calendar is probably counting from here. This is probably forgotten in time. Let us kind of avoid this topic because we honestly have no idea where we're trying to get to. But it will play out in assisting us in helping us better understand that there's change. I mean, just accept it. But we could, let us. Okay, that makes sense. Our role and responsibilities also should play a role in this because of free will. You see, that's probably the wobble of the earth. We give thanks because in some way or another we pray that and hope that ones can receive it. But somewhere or another, the wobble is the earth conscious out of control, and it's not the earth. It is us upon the earth, kind of just. Giving planet Earth or Mother Earth such a bad headache that her head is spinning And so this procession, if we don't get our acts together and our heads in the right place, and balance it out, then this will keep pushing forward that date. And so this is another evidence that truth is not is not just set. We play a very important role on truth. We exist in truth. I mean, how could that not be the case? So let us go on forward to the woman in the well, the oak tree, the oak, and stuff like that. So Shechem. Shechem is, excuse the handwriting. Shechem is in a depression. And then we have two mountains on the side, whether they be like Shur and Gerar, or whether they be Mount Ebal and Mount the other one, forgive me for not really knowing which one the other one, the name of the other one, but because we're not trying to get into those details, we're trying to present that this is the lower neck and this is the back and the shoulder blades and the doubling. So also it is very necessary to know that it's making decisions. Our decisions have everything to do with what takes place. If you make a bad decision, then you are shackled in chains to your past, and you will suffer, continue suffering, but the line of Judah shall break those chains. The main message, I guess we could say, is we have to cut ourselves out from the flesh before us. Stop following bad habits. Stop continuing negative cycles. We got to get cut off. In the situation of Sodom and Gomorrah, what happened? Lot survives, two daughters. I mean, the situation wasn't all that bad. Sodom got and Gomorrah got destroyed. Those people weren't all that nice, we could say. Yeah, they're ignorant, they're nice, but they weren't kind individuals and loving individuals. They were loving in a wrong way. Okay, so we got that. You just got saved. I mean, by the grace of the Almighty, in a miraculous kind of way, you got to witness like the destruction of a city. I mean, you're alone. You don't have to. You're alone in a mountain now. Eventually, Lot and his two daughters. You don't have to go to work anymore. You don't have to pay your bills anymore. You don't have. You're not in debt. You don't got bad credit no more. Everything's. It's like a fresh new beginning. I would be so grateful for that moment. I dread every day. The not. Not our in our lives, but we do not like having to pay bills and all that stuff, and so we would be kind of super excited, super grateful for that. And not only that, his wife is dead, I mean, that's a bonus. And it's not to disrespect no women or anything, but in this case, that female wasn't even able to keep a simple instruction as the one given to her, presented to her, do not turn around. That's it. That's all she had to do, and she was not able to keep that instruction. Now, it's not to kind of make assumptions or anything, but I'm not sure if that kind of person is trustworthy. Who and in a place like Sodom, we know what they were up to, and they wanted to Lot for him to bring out his visitors to do him, I mean, to know him, and they're all men, and they want to know men. I mean, and that lady wasn't able to keep instruction. Who knows what she was up to with all that wickedness surrounding her? So it's not that bad, She probably wasn't a good wife to begin with. So she turns around, she becomes a pillar of salt, and many many individuals would have been very, very happy. They would have been completely grateful for the situation. But what do? Every time something happens, we kind of get stuck. We get chained to our past. Moses draws us out of water. We don't have to We do not have to continue on the old ways. We can change. And so, but we don't, you know, this system programs us to continue doing wrong and not to self-evaluate, not to contemplate, to reflect, to meditate upon what has just happened. If Lot would have, you know, if someone would have told Lot what I just said, he would have been thrilled. He probably had been cheated on several times already. I mean, we're not, this is an assumption, right? But if you can't keep a simple instruction, chances are you won't keep any instruction. Now, so what we're trying to say is that we tend to follow bad patterns, bad habits. What happens? He got wasted. He didn't drink, all right? Yes, his daughters offered him drink. But you can only offer a cup at a time, a glass of wine at a time. It's on Lot. Lot was the one that decided to keep drinking. He was the one that decided to get so wasted that he had no idea that his daughter was, you know, that they were doing that. Not only that, it happened twice. All right? So it's following the bad patterns, you know? It's whether it be that, oh, we just got saved. Let's go out and drink. Oh, it's my birthday. Let's go out and drink. And it's not even to that point anymore. It's to the point, let's get wasted. I don't want to remember what I did last night, you know? Then we'll know we had a good time. So it's like, you know what? I had a bad day. Let's get wasted. I just got divorced. Let's get wasted. I just passed my classes. Let's get wasted. You know? And so it goes back to Noah. Noah did the same thing. Noah could have just drunk one glass. So how do we cope with our downfalls, with our depression? It's basically the whole point. Well, we tend to go further down. You know, we tend to do this. And that is not, and I'm not saying that I don't take this pattern, you know, but I mean, if this helps anyone, well, I hope it helps me too, you know, that's what I'm trying to say. So basically we have the mountains and then there's a curse and a blessing, right? But what we kind of want to present is this. Forgive me for this. We need to. Okay, we want to present this. Because this is Shechem. This is a depression. This is that time, you know, when we're talking about the forgotten years, the years that nobody wants to remember, obviously. Now we have, so we're trying to get up here, and it's obvious why. But this is the neck, and then these are your shoulder blades, right? Spinal cord, I guess. And these are your wings. If ones could even see that. Basically, we just wanted to kind of give like an idea of kind of how this, how it they are kind of like wings. Yeah, I guess that'll have to do. And then we have this part of the brain is really it's the lower brain. It's you got to get out of this place right here. But anyways, now this is the oak tree. You know, this is the oak tree, and where there is an oak tree, there is a well of water. This is the ein. This is the let I and I be single. This is the bird head. This is Horus. This is I guess like even the Maya and Egyptian are practically one and the same. They just have different ways. It's like, honestly, and it's not a joke, it's like Mayans were on acid and Egyptians were more like on something less severe or something like that, because honestly, it's kind of like what it breaks down to. Either some were on mushrooms, some other were on acid or something like that, because the art kind of explains for itself. Now, okay, we wanted to, and then, well, obviously this is, well, actually, let's get a beard on. This is God the Father. And then, okay, well, we're not gonna, I guess, let us go forward and present this. This is the limbic system. And then you have here something that looks like a bird, actually. But so just keep in mind that that all has to do the whole Egyptian heads. It's not worshiping gods. It's being really smart and very bright and knowing how to use what you can see to describe something that you can't see. This is another lesson to all. Everything that's coming, you won't necessarily see. You have to accept it before you can see it. It won't be seen all that physical. So get over the whole seeing is believing, because that is death. If believing is death, I don't want to believe. I want to know and I want to see. So this is, in fact, how it kind of the Eye of Ra, and then this right here leads to the this cycle right here leads to the reptilian brain, to the and the reptilian brain. It's not bad. That's why you don't kind of kill the dragon. You kind of just tame it. You have it under control. This is the competitive nature. This is the survival nature. This is only trying to get us to breathe and blink and just have our hearts going, so that we don't have to waste our higher mind in keeping the body going, because the body function is so, I mean, there's so many stuff that's taking place going on that it would just waste our time, and it would not allow for us to do more necessary things with our higher aspects of our brain and stuff like that. So that is where we are being kept. And we just came to the conclusion that it has nothing to do with the way that we are programmed and controlled. It has nothing to do with anything than the idea, until the philosophy that any nation is superior and another is inferior, until and so on and so forth. That is it, the competitive nature. It is Darwinism. The strong will survive, the strong will conquer. That is 666 and stuff like that. That is that pulls us down further into hell, because of the fact that that justifies anything you do to downpress the individual next to you, because that makes you stronger. So it does not create an environment of love and helping and coming up as a one, coming up as a society, as a world community. No, it means destroy your enemy, and you are better, so it's justified. It all has to do with that, basically. I mean, there's no way else to better describe what has led us to this destruction, to this way of life, and it's the competitive nature. But that is only to keep us going. We're supposed to dwell up here in the heavens, cometh with clouds. And for all those people out there that continue saying that this is only to be taken metaphorically, obviously it is. Check it out. I mean, we're doing it right now. Every root, every tree, same as above, so below. And so we're just trying to kind of make that connection. These are the lungs. And then, okay, let us stop right there. Just final note, we'll leave the next images for another presentation. We don't want it to get too long. For those people that that know all of this and that put this out there, and therefore make the assumption that they conclude the wrong idea, that because these are in fact true, that the Bible is not to be taken literal. I ask all Rastafari to be careful with that. Do not accept that. That is false. They cannot see it. You see, when someone says, philosopher, professors in philosophy say that you are supposed to question everything, but they don't, because they're presenting something to you, and the minute you question it, they question your questioning by saying it is completely false, because there is already a standard, and that is contradictory. Scientists, they try to create a subjective, I guess, like, they try to explain everything, but their roots, they come from not explaining anything, from not being able to explain it, and then they grow to be able to explain it. So they're questioning themselves, you know, they're not, everything is questionable. Don't get trapped with these people that do know a lot more than what I just presented, but they stop questioning and they limit truth. Then they'll say, but the Bible is not to be taken literal. And that is, whether it be consciously, wickedly attempting to I guess, like, confuse many, or they're doing it unknowingly, they're just ignorant, it's not been given to them. But there are many people just completely crediting the Bible with information set such as that which we presented, but then they'll say that it's not to be taken literal. If it's been manifest in everything, the seven witnesses, we have heavens, the heavens testify to this, the earth testifies to this. I mean, just look around, everything that's been written, it's happening. The scripture testifies to this. Gita Jesus Christos testifies to this. Now we have five. His Imperial Majesty testifies to Gita Jesus and to everything else. So now we have six. And we as Ras Teferi in the line of Judah Society, and we pray that even those without, we testify to this. So that is a perfect witness. We have seven testifying, seven different, seven in all of creation. We have heaven and earth, we have mind, we have soul, we have we're just playing with words here. We have a perfect witness. Ras Teferi, the scriptures can be taken literal. They must be taken literal. They must. How can you get to the next point if you don't first start with the word, and then the word being made flesh, and then the flesh being made spirit? This is life, you know. The words that Gita speaks, that is spirit, and that spirit is life. You know, so these people limit themselves, oh, but this is not to be taken literal. Those people do not know. Ras Teferi, this is the last message before we conclude. Do not fall victim to that, because they may be forgiven, and they may pass over to the next cycle, because what they're doing is ignorance. Ignorantly, they're saying what they're saying ignorantly. They cannot witness the glory of His Majesty. It has not been given to them. They are stuck in a low, even though they know supposedly a lot of stuff, but they're still here in a lower level. We are up here. To us, it's been given the heavenly things, you know. So they may be forgiven, and they may continue with living, but if we, knowing the heavenly things, reject it, then we are condemned, because we actually did know this and we gave it up. But they don't. They have no idea. Last note. Many think that the glory of God cannot be witnessed because it's too bright. We agree. Yeah, sure. That's why in darkness we see a shining light. Many think that God cannot come, they say come down, right? That God is so glorious that He cannot lower Himself to the humanly level, therefore we are not to expect God upon earth as a man. Well, That is people here in the depression. We meet the Almighty up here. You know? So, only him that came, we are to believe, we are to accept him that was sent from above to come down to us. But he's not coming down. He's, in a sense, it is, but he's only reaching a heavenly place. That is why so few people can testify to his majesty. Even though they see his majesty, even though they know who he is, they pretend that they don't. They cannot pass this firmament. It's not been given. They are here. They are in a depression. I mean, they honestly will pass over, not knowing a whole lot, not ever witnessing the glory of the Almighty. But we have, you see, we came up to this level, to the level where we don't judge and we just accept what is to be, and that being the ultimate challenge, meeting His Majesty up here. This is the congregation of the children of Israel. And this is the whole world. Oh, yeah, God doesn't exist, or he does, but he can't be a man, and he definitely can't be a black man, and he definitely can't be His Imperial Majesty. It makes too much sense. That scares the heck out of us. That means that we're going to have to do away with all of this and meet you guys up here. Meet you, Rastafari, up here. And that totally freaks us out. So we're going to get, we're stuck here in the oceans. You know, and we're up here, revelations and stuff. I guess we'll kind of, we'll, wow, this excuse me, alright, but, this is quite, this is something, this is actually, like, we just, you know, if we would have flipped this over here, this is the 23.5 degree tilt, this is the angel, and hitting us at the right angle, and this is the wobble, and the procession, this is all the people kind of confused and confusion, and so on and so forth, the firmaments, but then we have other firmaments up here, and, you know, the altar even. Well, I mean, enough said. We give thanks to everyone, you know, but first, to find our God and Father, Ketamawi, Hale, Shalasi, and through Geta Jesus Christos, in the Holy Spirit, which is our inheritance, you know. Africa shall shine. It is not a continent of darkness. Africa is Ethiopia, and Ethiopia is Zion, and we shall glorify Zion. Shalom, Rastafari.